Hello my dear students, welcome back to chemistry class. In the previous video class we have seen about the nucleophilic addition reactions of aldehydes and ketones, and also we have seen the oxidation and reduction properties of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, now beta, now remaining all the properties including uses, sara lesson ko main yahan par aapko complete kar deta hu beta. Okay, good. So in the fourth property, reactions due to acidic alpha hydrogen of aldehydes and ketones. In that, number one reaction is aldol condensation. So aldol condensation, it is a reaction, it going to be takes place between two same aldehydes and between two same ketones, and they should contain the alpha hydrogen atom. Okay, let me consider two same aldehydes. So that is nothing but two moles of otherwise CH3 bonded to C double bond OH, CH3 bonded to C double bond OH. And also I am going to be considered that another molecule of acetaldehyde, CH3 bonded to CHO. Both are nothing but acetaldehyde forms. So two moles of acetaldehyde, two same aldehydes we have to be considered, and they are having alpha hydrogen atom, functional group adjacent carbon. Yes, so the aldehydes which are having the alpha hydrogen undergo self condensation in presence of dilute bases. That is nothing but what, beta? Dilute NaOH. So now what is the intermediate we are going to be get here? So first molecule CH3, that one I am going to write as it is. And so, okay, now in that C, what is the group is there, beta? CH is there. Okay, I have written here. Double bond becomes what, beta? Single bond, because of such O minus, after delocalization of this bond, O minus goes to be attacked by H plus, which is coming from the alpha carbon. So simply we can say that OH nana. So one of the alpha hydrogen from second molecule shifted to the oxygen beta. Now remaining is nothing but what will be the group after shifting of hydrogen? Yes, the remaining is nothing but CH2. Again CH2 bonded to what, beta? CH2. So what is the name of this intermediate? Alpha compound, functional group adjacent is alpha, alpha adjacent is beta. So this is nothing but beta hydroxy aldehyde compound, and also we can say that alpha. Yes, sir, no, beta. Such beta hydroxy aldehyde compound, it is an unstable compound, followed by it upon heating, it undergo the process is nothing but dehydration. Water molecule ko remove kar dena. So how to remove the water molecule? From alpha carbon remove one H, and from beta carbon remove the OH group. Between alpha and beta, single bond becomes what, beta? Double bond. So now I want to write that CH3 bonded to CH. After that, after removal of OH group, single bond become double bond. After removal of H from alpha, it becomes CH. Again it connected to what, beta? CHO. So but 2-in-1-AL. So 2-butanol, and also we can say the another name of this compound is called, very important, this is called crotonaldehyde. Okay, so two same moles of acetaldehyde which are having alpha hydrogen atom upon dilute NaOH undergo self condensation and followed by dehydration gives alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. Okay, now beta, now this is the story by taking two same moles of aldehyde. Let me consider another example by taking two same moles of ketones, beta. Okay, another example I am going to be considered here. CH3 bonded to C double bond O, again bonded to CH3. Next, again CH3 bonded to C double bond O, again C double bond O bonded to CH3. So two same moles of acetone, two same moles of ketone I have taken here, that is nothing but acetone. Here functional group connected to the group is nothing but what, beta? Alpha carbon, alpha carbon, alpha carbon, alpha carbon. So so many alpha carbon, alpha hydrogens are there, beta, here. Okay, so that's why we can say that due to presence of alpha hydrogen atom, so two same moles of acetone, it undergoing what, beta? Aldol condensation. Okay, here also I am going to give the explanation. Same thing, undergo self condensation in presence of dilute NaOH or KOH, otherwise you can consider any dilute base. So CH3 bonded to C, yes, I am going to be right here as it is. After that, after delocalization of such bond above towards the oxygen, here single double bond becomes single bond. O contain the charge minus, that minus goes to be attacked by more acidic alpha hydrogen of second molecule. So yahan se ek hydrogen ko upar bhej do beta. Now it becomes OH. After that, what will be the remaining group? CH3. Again it connected to C double bond O, again it also connected to what beta? CH3. Samajh gaye clearly? Good. But here C connected to another methyl na beta? Yes, so that methyl I want to be right downside. Now this is again same thing. This is a functional group carbon, adjacent is alpha, adjacent is beta. So this is beta hydroxy ketone, and also we can say that this compound name is called ketal. Above one is beta hydroxy aldehyde, coming from the aldehyde, so we can say aldar. And this is coming from ketone, so we can say this is called ketal. Ketal again followed by upon heating undergo dehydration. So what will be the product here, beta? CH3 bonded to C. Yes, from C we are going to remove the OH group. Below plane that is nothing but CH3. And after that, after removal of H and OH between alpha and beta, single bond become double bond. Yahan se hydrogen remove kiye tumne, and remaining is nothing but what beta? C double bond O CH3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4-methyl pent 3-ene-2-ol. And also we can say that the another name of this compound is called mesityline oxide. Very important beta, mesityline oxide. Ye do bhi name perfectly remember karna padega. So 2 moles of acetaldehyde upon aldol condensation gives crotonaldehyde, and 2 moles of acetone upon aldol condensation gives what beta? Mesityline oxide. And if you know the common name, definitely the IUPAC names you can write easily beta. Okay. And sometimes they may ask the question in objective exam beta, sir, what is the intermediate in aldol condensation? So by taking 2 moles of acetaldehyde in that case, so the intermediate is intermediate by taking 2 same moles of acetaldehyde. So after removal of alpha hydrogen, we have to be say that CH2 bond CHO. Nothing but this is the intermediate. Okay, now in first example. And what will be the intermediate in second example? Again remove the alpha H plus. So we can say that CH2 minus, again bonded to C double bond O, it connected to what is a group beta? CH3. Kuch nahi, after removal of alpha hydrogen, H plus remove kar do, remaining CH2 minus. H plus remove kisiye, remaining CH2 minus. So these are the intermediates in the respective examples of aldol condensation. So maybe first example, maybe second, whatever that may be, C contain the charge minus. So we have to be say that the intermediate is nothing but carbeneon. Carbeneon, carbon contain the charge negative, not carbocation, carbeneon. Okay, now beta? Yes, aldol condensation theory, okay. So this is the condensation takes place between 2 same aldehydes or 2 same ketones. Next, I'm going to consider that cross aldol condensation. Which reaction beta? Cross aldol condensation. So cross aldol condensation, it going to be takes place between 2 different aldehydes and between 2 different ketones, and also we can consider 1 mole of aldehyde and 1 mole of ketone. So cross aldol condensation, it going to be takes place between 2 different aldehydes, and also we consider between 2 different ketones. Yes, and also we can consider that 1 mole of aldehyde, 1 mole of aldehyde, and what beta? 1 mole of ketone. 1 mole of aldehyde and 1 mole of ketone. Try to remember 2 different aldehyde, but at least one should contain alpha hydrogen. 2 different ketone, again in that at least one species should contain alpha hydrogen. And also we can consider 1 mole of aldehyde, 1 mole of ketone. In that also at least one species should contain alpha hydrogen. If both are having alpha, that is good. But condition is at least one species should be contain at least one alpha hydrogen. Samajhge? Now I am going to give the example by taking 1 mole of aldehyde, 1 mole of ketone. Okay, the aldehyde is nothing but acetaldehyde, CH3 bonded to CH2. And the ketone is nothing but what beta? Acetone, that is nothing but CH3 bonded to C double bond O bonded to CH3. Yes, both are having alpha hydrogen, okay, very well. But one is here what? Aldehyde, that is acetaldehyde, and one more is ketone, that is nothing but acetone. Same thing, they undergo aldol condensation in presence of dilute NaOH. And followed by we have to do heating. I am showing directly two steps. Step 1 and step 2. Okay, just the removal of water molecule. So how to remove the water molecule? From first molecule remove the O, and from second molecule alpha carbon remove 2 hydrogen. H2 combines with O and goes to be eliminated in the form of H2O. Remaining we have to declare that. Short me like that. Just eliminate the water molecule. From first species O, from second species alpha carbon 2 hydrogen. H2 and O removed in the form of H2O. Remaining is CH, now CH. So what will be your product? CH3 bond CH, double bond CH. Because of, after removal of oxygen, oxygen is a divalent. Okay, I have written 2 bond. यहाँ से तुमने 2 हाइड्रोजन रिमूव किए, रिमेनिंग इज नथिंग बट सी एच. नाउ सी एच बॉन्डेड टू सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ सी एच थ्री, सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ सी एच थ्री. ओके ना बेटा, सो व्हाट वी कैन राइट नाउ, 1 2 3 4 5. ओके, टेन 3 E 2 O लाइक दैट. यू हैव टू राइट द आई इंपैक्ट एंड यू कैन राइट इजीली बेटा. गुड. Next, another reaction I want to discuss with you, that is nothing but it is very important for objective point of view, that is called intramolecular aldol condensation. Intramolecular aldol condensation. Right. What is mean by intramolecular aldol condensation and how it is going on? Is one condition I am going to give you. Dicarbonyl compounds. Nothing but compound should contain at the time 2 C double bond O group. Two carbonyl rehna padega. Dicarbonyl compounds in presence of like above bases, methoxy and ethanol, they are going to form the intermediate product, that is nothing but 5 or 6 membered cyclic rings. So 5 and 6 membered rings, they are going to be formed. Dicarbonyl compounds upon intramolecular aldol condensation in presence of bases, they are going to form 5 or 6 membered cyclic rings. Okay, let me consider dicarbonyl compound, one of the example I am going to give you. 1 carbon, 2 carbon, 3 and this is 4 and this is 5 and this is 6. Samajh gaye na? Just let me consider one of the example, only 6 carbon. And you suppose C double bond O group present upon 2nd carbon and C double bond O group present upon 5th carbon. Okay? Good now. And C double bond O adjacent carbon is nothing, okay now here we can say that group is nothing but CH3. So C double bond O adjacent group is nothing but alpha. Okay? So what I have told you just now, from alpha carbon you have to remove the 2 hydrogen and from next molecule oxygen. So alpha carbon se kitne hydrogen remove karna, 2 hydrogen. And it's going to be connected with the 5th carbon, because of 5th carbon, carbonyl group is there. So from 5th position, we have to be remove the O, and from alpha position, we have to remove the 2 hydrogen. Nothing but it undergo the process is nothing but dehydration in presence of respective bases, ethyl alcohol. Okay, now you are going to get which membered ring? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 carbons are there. Nothing but you are going to get this part, a 5 membered ring. In that 5-membered ring, between that 5th carbon and alpha carbon, after removal of O and H2, okay, now, do ke beech mein kya form ho sakta? Double bond will be appear, ma'am. Okay, double bond. And next, 5th carbon connected to CH3, okay, 5th carbon connected to, here 6 is there, na beta? So, 5th carbon connected to CH3, that is nothing but 6th position. And, first carbon side, nothing but 2nd position contain double bond O. So this is 1st one and this is 5th one. 5th one connected to methyl and 1st one adjacent carbon contains C double bond. 1st one adjacent contains C double bond. This is the 5 membered cyclic ring. I want to show you another 6 membered ring now. This is the 1st carbon, that is nothing but CH3. And this is 2nd one and next one is 3rd one, 4th one, 5th one. And this is the suppose it is nothing but 6th carbon, it contains the group is C double bond O. And totally here how many carbons I have taken? 7. But first carbon is alpha, so you suppose from this we are going to remove the 2 hydrogen and from 6th carbon we are going to remove the oxygen. So bond will be makes like this one. Now you are going to get which membered ring? Again same thing after the elimination of water molecule. H2 removed from alpha carbon, O was removed from the 6th position. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nothing but now you are getting which membered ring? 6 membered ring. After removal of water, definitely there will be formation of double bond. and you suppose first carbon and sixth carbon. Sixth carbon connected to another carbon, this is nothing but seventh group. And first carbon, next side chain, first carbon adjacent group, okay, first carbon, next carbon, first carbon connected to another carbon, that carbon contains double bond of group. Like this. Okay, so this is the story about the reactions due to acidic alpha hydrogen of aldehydes and ketones. Samajh gaye beta? Good. Next, another property I am going to be discuss now. Reactions due to absence of alpha hydrogen. Which property we are going to be discussing with the reactions due to fifth one, absence of alpha hydrogen. Reactions due to absence of alpha hydrogen. Yes. So come on, tell me which type of compounds do not having alpha hydrogen. Yes, example I want to say that is nothing but formaldehyde, HCHO. Another example, benzaldehyde means benzene bonded to CHO. And another example we can consider chloral, CCl3CHO. Okay beta, this is the functional group, no more adjacent alpha carbon. This is a functional group, alpha carbon is there but no more alpha hydrogen atom. This is the functional group, alpha carbon is there but no more alpha hydrogen atom. So these three compounds, they will undergo the process. The process is nothing but Kennes-Arrows reaction. This is important, very 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 important. So which type of compounds they are undergoing Kennes-Arrows reaction? So the aldehydes and ketones which do not having any alpha hydrogen atom, they will prefer what beta? Kennes-Arrows reaction. So formaldehyde, benzaldehyde, and this is nothing but chloral, repeated question, no more alpha hydrogen. So all these three compounds, they are preferring what beta? Kennes-Arrows reaction. And try to remember Kennes-Arrows reaction, one more name is called self redox reaction, means it undergo self reduction and self oxidation. One molecule undergoes self reduction that gives alcohol, one more molecule undergoes self oxidation and that gives carboxylic acid. Let me consider first example. What is the formula of formaldehyde? HCHO, and also we can say that directly CH2O. No problem, no beta. So how many moles of formaldehyde we have to be considered? 2 moles of formaldehyde in presence of concentrated NaOH. So Kennes-Arrows reaction goes to be takes place in case of strong bases, but aldol plus aldol takes place in presence of dilute bases beta. And the first step is reversible but here first step is nothing but one beta, reversible in nature. So first mole of formaldehyde due to absence of alpha hydrogen in presence of concentrated NaOH undergo self reduction. Aldehydes upon reduction gives alcohol. Formaldehyde gives primary alcohol. One carbon alcohol is methyl alcohol, that is nothing but CH3OH beta. Okay na? Yes. And one more mole of formaldehyde undergo oxidation. Aldehydes upon oxidation gives carboxylic acid. So one carbon aldehyde changes into formic acid HCOOH. But due to its more acidic nature, that H can be H plus combines with OH minus and eliminated in the form of water molecule. Now position of H plus taken by the sodium. So one is nothing but alcohol, that is nothing but methyl alcohol, or we can say methanol. And one more is nothing but salt of carboxylic acid, that is nothing but sodium salt of formic acid, and we can say short name is nothing but sodium formic. Similarly, we have to be say that same beta, benzene group will be as it is. CHO becomes CH2OH, CHO becomes COONA. Nothing but one is benzyl alcohol, one more is nothing but sodium benzoate. So another example, same thing, benzene bonded to CHO. What is the name of this compound beta? Benzaldehyde. Okay. How many moles have to be taken? Same 2 moles due to absence of alpha hydrogen. It also prefers Kennes-Arrows reaction. So it upon reaction with same thing, concentrated NaOH. First mole of benzaldehyde undergoes self-oxidation, that gives self-reduction, that gives alcohol. Which alcohol? one hydrogen given to CH, it becomes CH2. Another hydrogen given to O, and that becomes OH. Nothing much. The alcoholic product is called benzyl alcohol. Again, benzyl here upon oxidation, second molecule changes into benzoic acid. Benzene bonded to COOH, but H replaced by NaOH due to its more reactivity. Samajh gaye beta? So this is nothing but sodium salt of benzoic acid, and also we can say that sodium benzoate. Sodium benzoate. Okay. So aldehydes and ketones, which are do not having any alpha hydrogen, in presence of concentrated NaOH, first species undergoes self reduction and gives alcohol. Second species undergoes self oxidation and gives carboxylic acids, and we can say that sort of carboxylic acid due to presence of sodium NaOH. Okay, na beta? Good. And try to remember one objective point. What is the main step in Kennedy-Rose mechanism? So the main step in Kennedy-Rose reaction is, transfer of hydride ion takes place. Nothing but transfer of H minus ion will be takes place. Hydride ion क्या होता बेटा? Transfer हो जाएगा between one molecule to another molecule, because of here we are taking two moles of formaldehyde. Okay beta, is a point remember karna padega. So the main point in mechanism of Kennedy-Rose reaction, transfer of hydride ion between two formaldehyde or between two benzaldehyde isolation. Okay, yes. And next property number 5 also completed. Next property number 6th one I am going to be discuss that electrophilic substitution reactions of benzaldehyde. Because of aliphatic aldehydes do not undergo electrophilic substitution, only benzaldehyde, nothing but aromatic aldehyde, it can be undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay na beta? Because of aromatic compounds will prefer the electrophilic due to resonance. Okay, in that directly I am going to show you one of the reaction. What is the formula of benzaldehyde? Benzene bonded to CH2. It upon, for suppose, chlorination is addition with chlorine. Chlorination takes place in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, nothing but we can take the Lewis acid. One of the hydrogen you can remove from the ortho place, that commands at Cl and goes to be removed in the form of HCl. Means ortho place replaced by Cl, and also para place also replaced by the Cl beta. So what are the two expected products here? Yes, one is ortho and one more is para. Such two products we can expect generally, but here in this reaction we are going to get only one product because of benzene bonded to CHO. CHO is nothing but electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing groups are only meta directors, but electron donating groups are ortho para, like phenol, like anisole, ortho para. But this is CHO group, withdrawing group. Withdrawing mein kya hota? Electrophilic attacking takes place only at meta position. So upon meta position, electrophile ko substitute kar dena. Okay beta, and above group is as it is. So benzaldehyde upon reaction with chlorine in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, that forms a product is nothing but metachloro or 3-chloro benzaldehyde. Metachloro benzaldehyde. Samajh gaye beta clearly? Good. Now I am going to discuss the another example. Yeah, which compound? Benzene. Benzene bonded to CHO. Nothing but again what beta? Benzaldehyde. It undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. That is nothing but reaction with concentrated nitric acid plus and reaction with concentrated what nana? Sulfuric acid. This mixture indicates nitration reaction. So benzaldehyde upon nitration, nothing but NO2 plus electrophile attacks it with place again meta place beta. So what will be your product here? Benzene bonded to CHO. Due to CHO withdrawing nature, incoming electrophile attacks it meta place. So what is the name of this product? Benzaldehyde. Upon nitration, means upon reaction with nitration mixture, it going to be formed. The product is nothing but meta nitro benzaldehyde. What is the product beta? Meta nitro benzaldehyde. Samajh gaye na clearly? Yes. So up to now we have seen clearly about the properties of aldehydes and ketones, which are inside the NCERT textbook. NCERT textbook ke sare properties khatam ho gaye. Now only two topics are left beta. One is decision use between aldehydes and ketones. Kya kya test use karte? and one more is nothing but uses of, okay, now 2 to 3 main important compounds to be discussed with. Yeah. So now we are going to discuss about the uses of aldehydes. Uses of aldehydes and ketones. Just a few of the selected compounds I want to discuss as per NCERT textbook. Good. In that, number one compound is acetaldehyde. CH3 bonded to CHO. CH3 bonded to CHO. What is the name of this compound? CH3 bonded to CHO. This is nothing but what? Acetaldehyde. So try to remember any uses of acetaldehyde, not for theory point of view, objective point of view. Main points I want to be focused. So by using acetaldehyde, we can prepare, or we can say it is used in preparation of paraldehyde, very important. It is used in preparation of paraldehyde. Sir, what is the formula of paraldehyde? CH3 bond, CHO, taken thrice. Means 3 moles of acetaldehyde upon cyclic polymerization, it going to form the product that is nothing but paraldehyde. Such paraldehyde contain the medicine nature, means it going to be used as hypnotic nana. So among the following, hypnotic medicine means answer is paraldehyde. That one we can prepare from acetaldehyde. And one more thing, try to remember. So by using acetaldehyde, we can prepare one more compound. AB important hai objective ke liye. Question, both the formulas, along with formulas and names repeated beta. Metaldehyde also we can prepare. So what is the formula of metaldehyde? CH3 bond CH2 taken 4, nothing but 4 moles of acetaldehyde upon cyclic polymerization that gives metaldehyde. So metaldehyde is going to be used as solid fuel. Agriculture field mein herbicides ke jaise bhi use kar sakte hain. Okay, good. So these two types of main medicines or chemicals, they can be prepared by using acetaldehyde. And one more thing, when acetaldehyde combines with ammonia, when acetaldehyde combines with ammonia, that forms the product is acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde on addition with ammonia, I have told you in yesterday class. After the loss of water molecule, we will get the product is imine. Which imine? Acetaldehyde. Yes, you are going to get the product is nothing but acetaldehyde. Such acetaldehyde is going to be used as rubber accelerator. Important question repeated beta. So this is the formula of rubber accelerator. So rubber accelerators, they are made by the reaction of acetaldehyde plus ammonia. That is nothing but acetaldehyde structure that going to be used as rubber accelerator. Samajh gaye clearly? Good. Next, another one I want to say that is nothing but benzaldehyde, benzene bonded to CHO. So any 2-3 benzaldehyde main methods I want to discuss here. Benzaldehyde is going to be used as flowering agent. Which is in beta? Flowering agent. So flavors ko support karegi beta. And also due to its flowering nature and due to its more number of carbon, yes, already I have told you, used in making fragrance, nothing but perfumes may be used as it. And one more thing is nothing but benzaldehyde, it was used in making dyes, especially green color dye we can prepare. The green color dye name is nothing but malachite. What beta? Malachite, important. So malachite is nothing but with green, sorry, which color beta? Green. So green color dye, that is nothing but malachite, it can be prepared by using what beta? Benzaldehyde. Next, another one I want to say with you, that is nothing but acetone. CH3 bonded to C11O, again bonded to CH3. So try to remember any 2 to 3 main importances of acetone ka remember kisi hai. Acetone can be used in making very important beta, nothing but cordite preparation bhi use kar sakte. Kahan par use karte? Cordite. What is mean by cordites are? So cordite is nothing but, try to remember, cordite is a smokeless powder. So in that making we can use what beta? Acetone. And auric point beta. Yes, acetone can be used in making nail polish. So nail polish preparation may be apni kya use kar sakte beta? We can use the acetone. Yes. And also one more thing I want to discuss with you. That is nothing but, So acetone, it can be used for storing acetylene. Acetylene को store करने के लिए भी use कर सकते हैं. For storing acetylene. What is the formula of acetylene? C2H2. So acetylene can be stored in. Answer is nothing but what, beta? Acetone. Yes, good. One more is nothing but I want to say that. Acetone, it can be used in preparation of very, very important. That is nothing but cellulose acetate. What, beta? Cellulose acetate. And also we can prepare cellulose nitrate also. But especially cellulose acetate. Try to remember one more name is called rayon. So rayon or cellulose acetate, it is a semi-synthetic polymer. It can be prepared. In the preparation of such cellulose acetate, we have to use acetone as the solvent. Samajh gaye beta? Yes. And one more thing, by using acetone, we can prepare chloroform, CHCl3. And by using acetone, we can prepare chloritone also we can prepare. What we can prepare, beta? Chloritone. So chloritone is nothing but one of the hypnotic drug, beta. Very important. Chloritone is a hypnotic drug. So today in this today's class, I have told you two hypnotic drugs. One is paraldehyde, hypnotic. One more is chloritone, hypnotic. So such chloritone, hypnotic drug and chloroform, both they can be prepared by using what, beta? Acetone. Samajh gaye? Yes, these are the few and very, very important uses of aldehydes and ketones, beta. Ye remember kaise bas ho jata. Okay na? Good na. Yeah. नेक्स्ट वन इज नथिंग बट डिस्टिंग्विश टेस्ट के बारे में डिस्कस करेंगे. यस, डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन which two compounds, beta? Aldehydes and ketones. Distinguish between aldehydes and ketones. Aldehydes and ketones को अपन किस किस मेथड से सेपरेट कर सकते हैं? Very important. 100% one question will be there. Okay. So in that number one, I want to discuss with you this nothing much. Yes, you know very well what, beta? Tollens test. And also we can say by using what we are doing, Tollens reagent, we are doing Tollens test. Okay, one by using Tollens test or we can say Tollens reagent. First of all, tell me, sir, what is the formula of Tollens reagent? Maybe repeat ho chuka hai exam mein. Yes, Tollens reagent is nothing but, try to remember, ammonical silver nitrate solution. This is your Tollens reagent. So how it is useful to distinguish the aldehydes from the ketones? So that is nothing but Tollens test, it is positive for yahi pe to focus karna padega. Tollens test is positive for aliphatic and aromatic aldehydes. Nothing but all types of aldehydes, they are positive for Tollens test. Nothing but aliphatic and aromatic acetaldehyde, formaldehyde, benzaldehyde, whatever that may be, all types of aldehydes on reaction with Tollens reagent, they are going to form the black precipitate. Which PPT? Black PPT will be formed, or we can say this black PPT is known as silver mirror. Which mirror? Silver mirror. That's why try to remember, beta, Tollens test, one more name is called silver mirror test. Because of on the walls of the test tube, Ag going to be deposited in the form of black color, in the form of silver, shiny nature. That's why we are saying this is called silver mirror test, or we can say black PPT formation test. So all types of aldehydes, aliphatic and aromatic, on reaction with Tollens reagent, they are going to form the silver mirror on the walls of the tube, or we can say black PPT formation. But ketones, they never form the silver mirror or black precipitate. Okay, so this is positive for aliphatic and aromatic aldehydes, and this is negative for ketones. Ketones, they does not form any type of silver mirror. Yes, so aldehydes are positive na beta. So how aldehydes are positive, how can you say that? Ek reaction mein aapko wahan par batana chahta hu. Okay, positive for aliphatic aldehyde, RCHO. In place of R, if you want, you can consider benzene, nothing but aromatic aldehyde. RCHO is nothing but aliphatic aldehyde. It upon reaction with toluene's reagent, 2 moles of AG, NH3 taking twice. This formula, try to be remember, A formula exam, repeat what you have done. And here the charge is nothing but plus. Means ammonical silver nitrate NO3 minus. वो remove करके आप हम plus लिख सकते हैं. No problem ना? Yes, this is nothing but Br, toluene's reagent. Ammonical silver nitrate solution means it is in aqueous condition or water condition that contain H plus and OH minus. For as per balancing, we required 3 moles of OH minus. Nothing but toluene's reagent solution undergo reaction with aliphatic aldehyde and also we consider aromatic aldehyde also, no problem. So simply we can say here aldehyde. Aldehydes upon reaction with toluene's reagent. Toluene's reagent also going to be act as oxidizing agent. So aldehydes upon oxidation gives carboxylic acid. So R bonded to C, COOH, but H is not available because of you have taken only OH minus. So simply we can say minus. So this is nothing but a carboxylic acid form, or we can say it is known as carboxylate ion. So aldehyde undergo oxidation. Aldehyde changes into carboxylic acids upon reaction with toluene's reagent. Remaining 2 moles of 4 nitrogen, nothing but we can eliminate 4 moles of ammonia. Next beta, and here 3 oxygens are there, 3 plus 4, but here only 2 oxygen. Remaining 2 oxygens are there, they goes to be eliminated in the form of water molecule. And here how many H's are there? 2 silver ions are there. After the formation of carboxylic acids, 2 moles of Ag that going to be settles down on the walls of the test tube. So this is the indication of formation of black precipitate, and we can say that silver layer, it going to be deposited on the walls of the tube and that experiment. Okay beta, good. So next one is nothing but second test I want to discuss here. Is the second test as per MCRT textbook syllabus is nothing but Fehling's test beta. Which test? Fehling's test. So by using how to do Fehling's reagent. Okay. Sir, what is the Fehling's reagent? So Fehling's reagent comes out of yes, I am going to write here. FR means Fehling's reagent equals to aqueous copper sulfate solution plus alkaline basic nature. Alkaline sodium or potassium. Sodium or potassium. Tartarate solution. Sodium or potassium tartarate solution. It contains one very special name. This is also known as Rochelle salt. Ye bhi repeat ho chuka hai mera exam mein. What is mean by Rochelle salt? Sodium and potassium tartarate. That is called Rochelle. Rochelle salt. Okay, all of you? Yes. So this entire mixture is known as Fehling's reagent. But try to remember, it is positive only for aliphatic aldehydes. So aliphatic aldehydes upon reaction with Fehling's reagent solution, this is Fehling A solution, this is Fehling B solution. Overall Fehling reagent will ke bolna padega. Okay. Aliphatic aldehydes on reaction with Fehling's reagent, they are going to give the confirmation. The confirmation is nothing but red precipitate, and its formula is nothing but Cu2O, Q plus oxide. Red PPT repeat hua, formula also repeated, which compounds are positive, repeated. So benzaldehyde is aromatic aldehyde, positive for toluenes. But benzaldehyde is negative for Fehling, because of benzaldehyde is aromatic aldehyde. Aromatic aldehydes are positive for toluenes, but negative for what? Kind of Fehling. So this is negative for aromatic aldehydes, nothing but benzaldehyde, and also what? Now ketones, they does not form any type of PPT. Once again, only aliphatic aldehydes are positive for Fehling's because of it forms a PPT. Aromatic aldehyde and ketones, they are negative for what? Now Fehling's reagent. First, suppose benzaldehyde, positive for toluenes, negative for Fehling, because of it is aromatic, negative for Fehling, and here for aromatic, positive for toluenes. So benzaldehyde we can distinguish by using toluenes and Fehling's reagent. Benzaldehyde positive for toluenes and negative for Fehling. Acetone positive, negative for both. because of ketones. Okay, now ketones, they are negative for both beta. Samasyaina? And two other reagents are there. That is nothing but one more is Benedict reagent. Benedict reagent. Samasyaina? Sir, what is the formula of Benedict reagent? Same like above, aqueous copper sulfate solution. And one more is same in nature, alkaline in nature, and same metals are sodium and potassium. Above one is tartarate solution, and below one is nothing but what beta? Citrate solution. Okay, now yes, once again. So, what is the formula of Benedict reagent? Aqueous copper sulfate solution. And a mixture of alkaline, sodium or potassium citrate solution. Tartarate use kiye to failing ban jata, citrate use kiye to Benedict banega beta. Okay na? Yes. So they are positive for what? Benedict test, it is positive for only aliphatic aldehyde. Same like failing. Failing positive for aliphatic aldehyde. It is also positive for aliphatic aldehyde. But in failing, the PPT is red PPT, and here the PPT is nothing but reddish brown PPT. Bas. Next, again Benedict test, it is negative for what beta? Same thing, aromatic aldehydes and ketones, nothing but benzyl aldehyde and ketone. So aromatic aldehydes and ketones, they does not form red PPT upon reaction with Benedict reagent. So we can say this are negative. So failings and Benedict, same functions. Positive for aliphatic aldehyde, positive for aliphatic aldehyde. And failings and Benedict, both are same. Negative for aromatic aldehydes and ketones. But here the precipitate is red, here the precipitate is red-brown, both are same PPT is nearby. Here is tartarate, here is citrate. What difference? And last and final solution, reagent. That is nothing but Schiff's reagent. Which reagent beta? Schiff's reagent ke baare mein discuss karna padega. Yes. Schiff's reagent. Sir, what is mean by Schiff's reagent? Schiff's reagent is nothing but aqueous solution of P rosaniline. One type of structure beta, aromatic structure. Aqueous solution of para rosaniline hydrochloride plus sulfur dioxide. This is the mixture. Aqueous solution of para rosaniline hydrochloride and sulfur dioxide. This mixture is going to be act as Schiff's reagent. Samajh gaye na beta? So what is the use of, how it is useful to distinguish? Its functions are same like toluene's test. Toluene's positive for all types of aldehydes. So aldehydes, they gives the pink color, nothing but they are positive. And ketones, on reaction with Schiff's reagent, that does not give any color, nothing but negative beta. One second. So toluenes and Schiff's reagent, both are positive for aliphatic and aromatic aldehyde. Aliphatic and aromatic aldehyde. Toluenes, aliphatic and aromatic aldehyde, silver mirror. Schiff's reagent, aliphatic and aromatic aldehyde, pink color. Yes sir, toluenes negative for ketones, Schiff's negative for ketones. Toluenes and Schiff's same, failings and Benedict same thing. Okay, all of you? Good. So, as per NCERT, okay, now okay, sare syllabus complete ho gaya beta. But one very important topic I want to tell you. Few of the very important previous repeated objective out of NCERT questions. Only repeated questions I want to discuss here. Just 4 to 5 reactions are there. Of course, here so many properties are there beta for aldehydes and ketones, but sare properties will discuss nahi kar sakte. As per okay, na, CET and NEET exam, few of the important reactions only I want to tell you, which are repeated in previous exams. Yes, is that number one? Yes, there is nothing but Perkin's reaction. Perkin's reaction. Only few of the important reactions I am going to tell you. Perkin's reaction. It is mostly preferable for the preparation of cinnamic acid. For cinnamic acid only we have to be used. So cinnamic acid can be prepared by using what beta? Perkin's reaction. So how to prepare cinnamic acid? Yes, first of all we have to be consider benzyl aldehyde, benzene bonding CH4. Perkin's reaction, benzyl aldehyde, it upon reaction with acetic anhydride, CH3 bonded to C double bond, you take in choice O. So benzaldehyde upon reaction with acetic anhydride, or we can say acid anhydride, impedance of catalyst is nothing but, or supporting base is nothing but NaOAC, nothing but sodium acetate. And you are going to get the product is cinnamic acid, nothing but benzene bonded to CH, double bond CH. Sir, how that we are getting? CHO, now say oxygen remove KCA. After removal of O, we have to be write double bond. And here CH3 carbon is there. CH3 say to hydrogen remove kar do, remaining is nothing but CH. And it connected to C double bond O group. Followed by yahan par hydrolysis bhi karna padega. So you are getting that number COOH. So we can say directly CH double bond CH bonded to COOH. This is your compound name, very 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 important, cinnamic acid. So among the following, cinnamic acid is suitably or fixedly prepared by the method is called Perkins reaction. Samajhena beta? Good. And another also I want to tell you, that is nothing but Noetjel reaction. Which reaction beta? Noetjel reaction. So what is mean by Noetjel reaction? Yes, so here I am going to take first of all acetaldehyde, CH3 bond CHO, or we can take CH double bond O. This is nothing but acetaldehyde. It upon reaction with malonic acid. Which acid beta? Malonic acid. CH2COOH bond COOH, malonic acid. And here reaction will be takes place simply upon heating. One of the CO2 will be removed in the form of, one of the COO group removed in the form of CO2. And here say O remove karo, from central C remove to hydrogen. H2 combines with O and goes to be eliminated in the form of H2O. Samajh gaye na? So remaining products, CH3 bond CH. After that a double bond is there. Central C is there. After removal of CO2, here hydrogen is left. Next group is nothing but COOH as it is. Yes. So what is the name of this reaction? Acetaldehyde. And what is the name of another reactant? CH2 connected to 2COOH group. This is called malonic acid. Malonic acid. Okay. Acetaldehyde on reaction with malonic acid, it going to be formed, the product is called protonic acid. Very 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 important. Benzene hai samjho, cinnamic acid. Benzene ke paas CH3 hai samjho, protonic acid. So cinnamic acid we can prepare by Perkins reaction, but by using Noetjel reaction we can prepare protonic acid, and also we can prepare cinnamic acid also. How? In place of CH3 we have to be take benzene. Nothing but क्या लिख सकते हैं अपन? So we can say benzene bonded to CH2. Compound name is nothing but benzaldehyde. And also we can say CH double bond O. Same thing, it upon reaction with malonic acid. Upon heating, it going to be lose everything same. In place of CH3, we have to be take what with benzene. So benzene bonded to CH double bond CH bonded to COOH. So the compound name is called cinnamic acid. Which acid beta? Cinnamic acid. Now how to say the, okay na, apkan kaise pronounce karna padega? Yes, acetaldehyde upon reaction with malonic acid gives protonic acid, and benzaldehyde upon reaction with malonic acid it forms a product is called cinnamic acid. Samjhe na beta? Important, try to be focused. Yes, next one is nothing but I want to say that 3 moles of formaldehyde, 3 moles of formaldehyde upon imprimance of concentrated cyclic H2, imprimance of concentrated H2SO4, it undergoes cyclic polymerization. It undergoes cyclic polymerization. And the product is nothing but HCHO taken thrice, or CH2O taken thrice. And also we can say that the structure is called CH2O bond CH2O. Again O connected to CH2. Again it is connected to O. So same nana, both are same formulas. This is called trioxane. Which oxane? Trioxane. You are getting from which compound? Formaldehyde. So listen carefully. Three moles of formaldehyde upon cyclic polymerization gives trioxane. And already I have told you, 3 moles of acetaldehyde upon cyclic polymerization, the product is CH3CHO taken thrice. So the product name is called paraldehyde. Yes, just now I have told you, you do it as hypnotic. And one more, 4 moles of acetaldehyde. Again, same thing upon cyclic polymerization. The product is nothing but CH3 bonded to CHO taken 4. But it is nothing but what, beta? Metaldehyde, which is used as solid fuel. So 3 moles of formaldehyde upon cyclic polymerization gives trioxane, 3 moles of acetaldehyde gives paraldehyde, and 4 moles of acetaldehyde gives metaldehyde. So these are the 3 cyclic polymerization products. Another 2 reactions are left, beta. Next, again I am going to take here 3 moles of acetone, CH3 bonded to C double bond bonded to CH3. 3 moles of acetone. Such a 3 moles of acetone, now you suppose it undergo cyclic polymerization, same by using concentrated water and sulfuric acid. Concentrated sulfuric acid, cyclic polymerization using concentrated H2SO4. And here you are getting the product is called mesityrene, very, very, very important. Benzene bonded to CH3, benzene bonded to CH3, again here also CH3. 3 CH3, they should be in alternate positions. Nothing but 3 here, how many oxygens are there? 3 oxygen, so they goes to be eliminated in the form of water molecule. So 3 moles of acetone upon cyclic polymerization in presence of concentrated H2SO4, it forms the product is called mesityrene. This is the repeated question already. Mesityrene. Good. Now I am going to take 2 moles of acetone. CH3 bonded to C double bond, again bonded to CH3. Same thing, 2 moles of acetone. And now you suppose it undergo polymerization, but not in presence of H2SO4, in presence of concentrated water, beta, HCl. Concentrated HCl. And that too, one more thing, this above one is nothing but cyclic, and this is normal polymerization, nana. Yes, simply here elimination of water molecule takes place. So 2 moles of acetone upon HCl, it gives mesityrene oxide. 3 moles of acetone upon H2SO4, it gives mesityrene. 3 moles gives mesityrene, 2 moles gives mesityrene oxide. So the formula of mesityrene oxide is CH3 bonded to C double bond O, again bonded to CH double bond C, in bracket CH3 taken twice. This is your product, mesityrene oxide. So 2 moles of acetone gives mesityrene oxide and 3 moles of acetone gives mesityrene. Mesityrene is a cyclic polymer and this is nothing but open chain polymer. And here in case of H2SO4, here in case of HCl. To that mesityrene oxide, you can add another mole of acetone. Again, same thing in presence of concentrated HCl. Now also, here also we have to remove the water molecule. So how to remove the water molecule? Kuch nahi. Yahan se O remove karo. Yahan se 2 hydrogen remove kijiye. Okay, central is nothing but C double bond O. Right side it connected to CH. CH double bond C. C in bracket main. CH3 taken twice. And what about left side? After removal of 2 hydrogen, remaining is only CH. After removal of 2 hydrogen, we have to be write double bond. And next it connected to what? C. C contain how many methyl group? 2 methyl groups. So both sides the same group. This is our very, very important compound. This is called forol. Kya bolte? Forol. So mesityrene oxide and forol, they goes to be used as solvents, especially in paint preparation. They use concept. And last and final reaction I want to tell you here. 6 moles of formaldehyde upon reaction with 4 moles of ammonia, nothing but 4 moles of MH3, Yes, six oxygens are there. Upon heating, they goes to be eliminated in the form of six moles of water molecule. Remaining CH2 taken, six. And total four nitrogens are there, N4. This is your product name, HMPA. And also we can say another name is called urotropine. Very, very important. So formaldehyde on reaction with ammonia gives urotropine, or we can say hexamethylene tetraamine, HMTA. Hexamethylene tetraamine, this is called urotropine. What beta? Urotropine. So urotropine can be used for urinary infections. Urotropine can be used for what beta? Urinary infections. This is the question already repeated. Among the following, which is used for the treatment of urinary tract infection, that is nothing but urotropine medicine, or we can say HMTA. One more important beta, such HMTA, what is the formula? CH2 taken 6 N4, hexamethylene tetraamine. So such HMTA or hexamethylene tetraamine undergo reaction with nitration mixture. Nothing but upon nitration. HMTA upon nitration, it going to be formed a very important product. This is called RDX. So RDX preparation may be upon kya use karte beta? Urotropine use karte. So HMTA or urotropine upon reaction with nitration mixture, it forms RDX. Nothing but research and development explosive material. RDX, research and development explosive material. So these are the few of the out of NCERT reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Each and every reaction, it was repeated in previous maybe NEET or KSET. Sare exam repeat ho chuke beta. Okay na? And some more reactions are there, but up to there we don't need to go. Okay, now if anything will become done, try to make practice. If you are not going to understand, ask me. So okay, aaj apna kya finish ho gaya? Aldehydes ketones topic khatam ho gaya. So kal ka class mein, I mean in tomorrow's class, I'm going to start the topic carboxylic acids. Samjhe na beta? Try to make practice. Aldehydes and ketones, very important chapter. It is nothing but okay, na, spinal cord of the organic chemistry beta. Okay? Yes.